This is a 32 caliber bullet shot from a handgun into ballistic gelatin that is designed to be the density of human muscle. And this is a 223 caliber 5.56 NATO bullet shot from an AR-15 style rifle into ballistic gelatin. These videos were created in a crime lab to compare the tissue trauma caused by these two different bullets traveling at vastly different speeds, generating vastly different amounts of energy. Dr. Eric Fleegler is one of the nation's leading researchers on firearm injuries and reduction strategies.
You know, when you watch those videos, they're very striking. So you watch this first bullet go through, and what you see, of course, is that it cuts a path straight through it. You see some reverberations, get a sense of the kind of the damage that must occur as the shockwave kind of spreads throughout. And then it settles down and it leaves kind of a trace behind it. And then you see the bullet from the AR-15 style rifle go through. And it's, to be very frank, I think quite shocking to watch. And the bullet is passing through in a fraction of a second. The reverberations across the entire gel are ongoing. And it just gives you a sense, you can kind of imagine this going through the human body and how it just shreds things. What you don't see are the blood vessels that tear. What you don't see is when an organ kind of basically explodes. You don't get a sense of that kind of destruction. So, if anything, I find these ballistic gels really undercount or undersell just how much damage is being done.
Dr. Steve Hargarten has treated hundreds of gunshot victims over his career. Here, Dr. Hargarten demonstrates a 32 caliber handgun, the same caliber used in the first ballistic video.
This is a 32D Davis over-under Derringer. It's over-under, so the bullet goes here in the breech. Now it's ready to be used. It's a single action. Pull the trigger back, pull the trigger. Over the last couple of years, we've been intensely testing bullets in collaboration with the Wisconsin Crime Lab to quantify the bullet's release of kinetic energy as it travels through the gelatin. We now have high-speed video cameras to be able to do this as never before. And we feel this is like the microscope of understanding firearm injury. The mass of an AR-style 15 rifle bullet is actually smaller in terms of weight than a 32 caliber bullet. And so the caliber of the 32 is 0.32. AR-style 15 rifle caliber is 223. It's smaller caliber. So the mass is really not the issue compared to the velocity. And what drives the injury to a person with a bullet is the velocity.
In the ballistic test, the 32 caliber bullet from a handgun is moving at a velocity between 925 to 1100 feet per second. But the 223 caliber 5.56 NATO bullet from the AR-15 style rifle is moving at a velocity of 3251 feet per second. The handgun delivers a muzzle energy of 123 to 161 foot-pounds, while the AR-15 style rifle delivers a muzzle energy of 1,300 foot-pounds. That's a muzzle energy 10 times higher than the handgun.
And that's really what Stoner and others in the 50s, when they're developing this product, they wanted a lighter weight bullet that could deliver a significant amount of energy, and thus a significant injury leading to significant impairment or death.
So how will this research in ballistic testing impact medicine?
As we advance these investigations, we think this is going to further inform the curriculum in medical schools and in surgery programs, because now we have the microscope for this disease. We really want to apply that so that when the students are learning about what's happening with a bullet in its behavior inside a tissue, we can better understand the evolution of hemorrhagic shock and other tissue damage, nerve damage, and that further informs questions that residents have and then surgeons have about the care of patients. So we think this is the start of that kind of influencing curriculum, influencing training, and influencing care.
Firearms are one of the leading causes of fatalities in the United States. And when it comes to actually youth up to the age of 19, are the number one killer of children in the US. In other words, if you die between the age of 1 and 19 in the United States, the likelihood that a bullet was involved is almost 1 in 4. So what do we do about it? We need better research. We need to understand who's getting hurt, why they're getting hurt. All of this type of information will make us better informed so that we can make an informed decision about who should or should not be able to get these bullets, what type of bullets should be sold, and what should the cost be associated with them.